your strong master Lily.
And Lulu.
All right. We've only just begun our reaction journey with the only Beatles. And I'm just thinking what to react to from them. Because their catalog is so big. Like, honestly, so many good songs. In fact, today we were listening. We were at dinner. There was a guy on a guitar playing, you know, in a little band. And there was, I'm like, this song's awesome. Who sings it? Google looked, the Beatles. I'm like, I didn't know that.
So, well, they have so many songs.
So many songs and so many good ones. But this one here, I didn't want to miss because people say this performance is their best one yet. I guess they're performing in front of a bunch of people. Mm. They got to like, experience Beatles live. I'm like, oh, my God. What? I would have loved to be able to have them play for me live like that. That would have been an experience forever to tell your kids about. So, yeah, Hey Jude.
Oh, love this song, right?
One of the best. I feel like I got to at least share with you like some fun facts about this song. Actually, I was a little surprised. I thought this song came out like during the heyday of the 70s because it felt very much one of those, you know, free love era type of songs. But they recorded this back in the 60s, actually. So it was actually one of their older songs.
Wow.
It was also one of their longer songs. Like it clocks in at like over 7 minutes, which is, I think, very unusual back then because I feel like a lot of the Beatles stuff, especially the early stuff, the rock stuff, every song was like 2 minutes long. Because I always felt like when I was listening, like it's already over. I want like at least another verse. But this song, there's something about a slow burn. Like it's the buildup for it is so good. And it was a, massive hit, reached number one of the charts, multiple countries across the world, and it stayed in the Billboard Top 100 for over 9 weeks. The longest running Beatles singles at number one. Yeah. Every time it comes on the radio, absolutely, everything stops in the car. We stop fighting, and boom, we just pull over, and we just sit back, we absorb it. It's that good. All right, let's check this out, y'all. By the way, if you want to hear some wicked, wild stories, you got to check out my channel.
And if you want some hotness, check out my fantasy show.
Ooh, I think this must have been filmed after the 60s then. This very 70s vibe. Magnificent. Doing a full scat.
Magnificent. A perfect rendition. Ladies and gentlemen, there you see the greatest tea room orchestra in the world. It's my pleasure to introduce now in their first live appearance for goodness knows how long in front of an audience, the Beatles.
It's now on!
What the This is on the Beatles side. They left it like this.
Hey Jude, what? Don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better.
Wow, very intimate.
This is very, it's like close.
To let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better. Hey
Don't bum rush to the stage.
Wow.
That is intimate. Like, it's like too close.
I think he's drunk.
I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if musical instruments and props go missing after this. I would go take that and sell it somewhere. God, that's got to be like a memory of a lifetime to be there. Holy moly. They would never allow people to do that today with music artists like that, to get that close. While they're playing, like, hey, can I go along with you? Like, right there on the piano, sitting on the equipment.
Maybe there was some.
It feels like an era when people, like I said, the free love era, right? Like, it's just love for everybody. Come, there's no wall between us as superstars or you as, everyday
fans. And also, if they do this, for sure, they will have to prep them all. Do not touch them or don't be, all that stuff for sure.
Well, you crowded
that
like that. Yeah. Mr. Flower Power there. I feel like he's going to, he probably fondled a couple of the Beatles at that point. Oh, I mean, they must have planned that because it was, it was just quiet on the set. And then suddenly, boom, at that part, everyone rushed on. It almost felt like Black Friday. Like, you got to come in as quick as possible, get the last TV.
I want to be right there.
Exactly. Right? You want to be right on the keyboard. Guys, oh, my goodness. That was
awesome. That was so special, right? To be able to be like, I was there. See that? to my grandkids.
God. Oh,
this
my
song,
goodness.
The na 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 is the one that makes it too long. It's probably like the 2-3 minutes.
Too long? You dare say this song's too long?
No, because we mentioned how it was like 7-8 minute song, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So it's that's a what slow it is. Burn. Like, nah. They just like get into it, but, and then it's like a trance. It's like,
right. Oh. But then at the same time, you don't feel like, when is this going to end? Nah, nah, nah. That's the strange part, because you just love it.
Because he keeps going at it. Like, in fact, you hear Paul McCartney just getting louder, because at some point, you're like, all right, it's got to end. Right? It's got to end.
That's what
but
I'm
the
saying.
But the na na na, it feels like, all right, one more time, y'all, and everyone suddenly
yeah,
with it.
I mean,
it's
I'm,
the perfect song
I'm
to sing along to
sing
because you
na-na-na.
Know how to sing na na na.